1 other second is 10 to the minus 18 seconds, which is extremely, extremely short. So the ratio between 1 attosecond and 1 second is roughly the same as the ratio between 1 second and the age of our universe. Anything that just has like electrons moving around is on this time scale. For example, in like photosynthesis, it happens on like attosecond, femtosecond time scales. Or in chemical reactions, anytime the electrons start moving first before the atoms are following, that happens on an attosecond time scale. But it's always electrons moving because anything else is just too heavy and takes way longer. Attosecond science is when we shoot atoms or molecules or sometimes even surfaces with really, really short laser pulses and monitor what electrons are doing. And the electrons, how they're moving in their bound states or how they're going from a bound state to a ionized free state in the continuum. And these motions, they happen on an attosecond timescale. One particular method that we use in attosecond science, it's called Attoclock, and it's a method that tries to measure the time it takes an electron to tunnel through a potential barrier. This question has been around for a long time, basically since the beginning of quantum mechanics, where the tunnel effect has been described first. People started wondering, well, okay, if this particle is going through a part of space which classically it isn't allowed, does that take some time? And if yes, how long does it take? Attoscience basically gave us a tool to try and measure that, because these ultra-strong fields, they basically take the Coulomb potential and bend it down so that we have a triangular barrier. So the ionization event that happens is not the electron gaining energy by absorbing photons. It's actually the electrons tunneling through this potential barrier. So we have a laser field which is incredibly fast, which can monitor electron movements on an incredibly fast timescale, and we have an electron moving through a potential barrier. So the idea was to combine that and have an approach to measure how long does it actually take. Well, we don't know yet. We have an idea of like it could be maybe somewhere around, for the particular case that was measured, roughly of the order of like 100 attoseconds. But then again, there's been a huge debate about this topic. So there's, when I talk to people who are not directly in the field, one of the first just throw out statements is always, well, why don't you just calculate Schrödinger's equation and you get the solution? But even when people just use Schrödinger's equation, do their calculations, they end up with opposing conclusions. So some say, hey, it actually happens instantaneously. And others say, hey, no, it actually takes some time. So it's not quite clear yet. So my work has mostly been on the side of, yeah, it might take some time. We don't know yet how long exactly, but some finite time, maybe, probably. But then again, like for the most intuitive argument for instantaneous, besides all the calculations, is just that, hey, the wave function is everywhere anyway. It's just like the amplitude is highest in the bound state. But there is some, even if it's infinitesimally small, part of the wave function which is already outside the atom anyway. And that's just the part that grows in amplitude. So that's a very intuitive, like non-mathematical idea behind, hey, it happens instantaneously. I mean, the reason why this is so incredibly complicated is the fact that time is a parameter in the Schrödinger equation. It's not an observable. There's no unitary operator that we could use to just apply it like a position operator or a momentum operator or an energy operator or anything like that. So we have to find kind of alternative observables and try to reconstruct then the timing of the whole process in different approaches, like brute force time-dependent Schrödinger equation solutions. There have been approaches by using Bohmian trajectories. There have been approaches by using Wigner transforms. And they all end up with contradicting results, unfortunately. So, yeah.